Hello, in this video, we will talk about growth hormone secretion. First, we will see some basics about the release, and then we will see how growth hormone release is regulated. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. Growth hormone is a major regulator of the body's growth. It is released from somatotroph cells in the anterior pituitary gland. A peculiar thing about release of growth hormone is that its release occurs in pulses. If we measure plasma level of growth hormone throughout the day, we would find maximum levels during night. That is because its release is maximum during early hours of sleep, and more than 70% of total daily growth hormone release occurs during slow wave sleep. So that was the basic. Now let's talk about the regulation of growth hormone secretion. Three main regulators of growth hormone release are growth hormone releasing hormone, somatostatin, and ghrelin. Let's first talk about growth hormone releasing hormone. This is hypothalamus. This is arcuate nucleus in hypothalamus. And this is hypothalamic hypophyseal portal blood vessel. Small bodied neuron in arcuate nucleus synthesize and release growth hormone releasing hormone in the veins. From here, it goes to the somatotrophs in the anterior pituitary. Here they bind with growth hormone releasing hormone receptors on the cell membrane of somatotrophs. Now, these GHRH receptors are G protein coupled receptors associated with GS protein. Its stimulation activates G alpha S, that in turn stimulates adenylyl cyclase. Adenylyl cyclase converts ATP into cyclic AMP, resulting into rise in cAMP level. Now, the increased cytosolic cAMP level produces two effects. In short term, it opens calcium channels that lead to inflow of calcium. Increased calcium level triggers release of growth hormone which was already stored in the vesicles. Second, in long term, it stimulates gene transcription which results in the synthesis of more growth hormone. Thus, the growth hormone releasing hormone increases the synthesis and release of growth hormone. Next is somatostatin. It is mainly synthesized in the periventricular cells of the hypothalamus. It is also made in pancreatic islet delta cells and D cells in the GI tract. From the periventricular region of the hypothalamus, somatostatin is secreted into long portal veins. Now it goes to the somatotrophs. Here it binds with G protein coupled receptors called SSTR. In contrast to GHRH receptors, which was GS coupled, this one is coupled to GI protein. And this one inhibits adenylyl cyclase. As a result, all the subsequent steps that we saw earlier are prevented and eventually release of growth hormone decreases. Thus, somatostatin inhibits release of growth hormone by somatotrophs. An important thing to note here is when somatotrophs are exposed to both GHRH and somatostatin, the inhibitory action of somatostatin predominates. Now let's come to the third hormone controlling the release of growth hormone, ghrelin. It is mainly released by distinct endocrine cells within the mucosal layers of stomach fundus in response to fasting. However, endocrine cells throughout the GI tract can also release ghrelin. The arcuate nucleus of the hypothalamus also makes a small amount of it. Ghrelin stimulates growth hormone secretion, which stimulates body's growth. Ghrelin also stimulates appetite, which indirectly contributes to growth. So that was ghrelin. Next, we have negative feedback control of growth hormone secretion. For that, let's quickly see what we saw earlier in this diagram. Growth hormone is released from somatotrophs. Growth hormone releasing hormone stimulates its secretion and somatostatin inhibits its secretion. Now, there are multiple loops for negative feedback. First, growth hormone inhibits its own secretion via short loop feedback on somatotrophs. Second, growth hormone triggers the secretion of IGF-1 from growth hormone target tissues throughout the body, mainly from the liver. IGF in turn inhibits growth hormone release either by direct or indirect pathway. In the direct pathway, IGF-1 suppresses the somatotrophs directly. Indirect pathway goes via growth hormone releasing hormone and somatostatin. Here IGF-1 suppresses growth hormone releasing hormone release and increases the secretion of somatostatin. Both these actions result in decreased secretion of growth hormone. So in this way, both growth hormone and IGF-1 can decrease growth hormone secretion. Besides these hormones, certain other factors can also affect growth hormone secretion. So let's talk about them. Among the factors that stimulate growth hormone secretion are decreased blood glucose, protein deficiency, decreased blood free fatty acids, exercise, stress, starvation or fasting, testosterone and estrogen, and deep sleep. Hypoglycemia stimulates growth hormone secretion, especially under acute conditions, while protein depletion is a potent stimulator during chronic conditions. Now, the factors that decrease growth hormone secretion are increased blood glucose, increased blood free fatty acids, and obesity. Growth hormone secretion also decreases with aging, whereas its secretion is at peak during puberty. So these were all the factors controlling the secretion of growth hormone. Now let's have a quick summary. Growth hormone is released by somatotrophs in the anterior pituitary. Growth hormone releasing hormone causes synthesis and release of growth hormone, while somatostatin inhibits its release. Growth hormone inhibits its own release by negative feedback effect on somatotrophs. IGF-1, which is secreted in response to growth hormone, directly inhibits growth hormone release by suppressing somatotrophs. Indirectly, it suppresses growth hormone releasing hormone release or increases secretion of somatostatin, both of which in turn inhibits somatotrophs. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.